All right, guys, welcome back again. It's been a few weeks since I did a video, but today we're gonna do a video on something I've been waiting for a long time. If you guys follow me on Instagram, then you probably already know this is the thing I've been waiting on. It was a pre-order and they finally came in. So we're gonna show you that here today. It is the Oracle taillights for the JT or the Jeep truck Gladiator. So they're gonna replace these big pimple looking things that are on the side. You can see they stick out quite a bit. And these are gonna be flush mount. A lot of people were saying they're having some issues with these, but mainly those are on the halogen tail lights and the headlights, the halogen package. But I have the LED package, so hopefully it's going to work out well. We're going to install those today. But all right, so here they are. Get these open. Okay, there's a couple instructions. Oh, of course, their Oracle has their little decal lights, and here they are, guys. Really light. I mean, the other ones weren't that heavy, but these are really light. You got your wires, got your resistor, your clip plugged in here and here. Really thin. You can see compared to the originals, how thick they are on the side. And these are flush mount. So you can see really quite a bit of difference, real thin. So, all right, let's get these put on. All right, so one of the things I wanted to show you guys was the two different plugs here. So this main larger one is for the truck. It goes in the main harness. This right here is for your cross traffic or blind spot sensor. You're not going to use this if you don't have that sensor. And you can see I don't have that sensor. It would mount right here on this plate. Now, another thing you can see is this resistor that I showed you that it had. I mounted it to the light itself. Because I didn't want it dangling. I didn't want to mount it to the truck. I wanted it all to be right here. If you don't have the cross traffic sensor, I just went ahead and mounted it right there to this plastic piece. And what I did was I used my own screw. They don't provide any mounting screws for this resistor. So you have to find your own. Just a small little screw. This is plastic and it didn't go through or anything like that. You can see that it's just right in here, just like that. So now all we got to do is plug it in. Flip this over, plug it in the way that it came out, make sure it snaps. Once it snaps, put your red thing clip up. This I'm just going to leave hanging in there like that. Make sure it doesn't, it's supposed to be flush mount, and it's not really that flush mount, to be honest with you. I mean, they're in there, but they ain't in there tight. Ah, I see what it is now. I see. Okay, here's a little tip, a little trick, what we're going to do. So these prongs right here are pretty long, okay? And let me show you these little rubber grommets right there. They're not actually grommets. What they are, if I can pop one out here, I'll show you. They have a back to them. So I can see now we're going to have to take a pair of wire snips probably and punch out the back of these. See, that's the problem. These are solid on the back and these are too long, as you can see here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take and pop out the back end of those with a pair of pliers so this can go all the way through, because right now it's not wanting to go all the way through. So I guess you need to do that on the top and bottom. So that's definitely a trick, a tip that I can give you guys. And we'll do that and then see how it goes after that. All right, so I got a little snips here. Just snip off the end. Look at there, there's a hole all the way through it. So now, these will go all the way through and it's still pretty tight. So that's definitely something that you guys want to keep in mind whenever you're doing this. Highly recommend doing. And we'll just pop it right back into the hole that it came out of. I'll show you guys where that's at. Again, right there, there's one there and there's one up there. You can kind of see right there. So pop a hole in the back of both of those. And this will be able to go on nice and tight, nice and secure. All right, yeah, that's way better. It fits nice and tight in there. We'll screw it down, but there's no gaps. It pushes all the way back, nice and tight. So we'll go back and do these, put the screws back in to retain it, and then we'll be done with this side, moving on to the next side. Alright, so as you guys can see, I got both sides on now. Really looks good. Don't have those big pimples on the side. These are definitely what should have came with the truck to begin with, in my opinion. No issues whatsoever with them. They blink normal speed. They work as functionally supposed to. Looking forward to what they're going to come up with here. They already got a reverse light. This may be another accessory light of some sort, or I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what they come up with. Maybe another red reflector right there, maybe. I don't know, but or just leave it like that. It's fine too. So what we're going to do now is, if you guys remember one of my other videos, I installed these lights, semi-installed. I say that because they haven't been hooked up for the last few months. So what we're going to do now is wire in those to the auxiliary switches on the Jeep, and that way I can actually use them and use the side shooters to see the ditches on my back road on the way to work and on the way home to look for deer, because they are starting to come out for sure. So let's get those wired up now. All right, so wiring up these lights. So what I did was reach up in through here, grabbed the wire from the lights, put them down through the cowl, okay, and then here ran the wire this way. There is a spare ground that's right here. So this is the ground for the truck, and then this is a spare one. It didn't have anything on it, so I grounded it there. And then right down here in this wire harness, you will see these four wires. These are for your aux switches, okay? And to figure out which one we're gonna need to connect to this power wire, go into your owner's manual. You're gonna go to page 79, and this is what you're gonna find, okay? So there's four aux switches, different amperage, 40 amp, 40 amp, 15, 15. These are gonna be for the lights, they're gonna be 15 amp is all I need for these LEDs. So we can either use aux 3 or aux 4. So if you look up there to see which one we're gonna need, which one we're gonna use, so I'm gonna do aux 3, okay, top right corner, and use that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to need to find the orange and pink wire in my engine bay, 15 amp. For aux 3, auxiliary 3 switch. So pink and orange. Okay, so it's gonna be this one right here, pink and orange. So that one right there is what we're gonna use. There's also the green and pink, the purple and pink. We're gonna use this small one right here, the pink and orange. So these are the two 15 amp ones. These are the two 40 amps. So we're gonna use this one right here, connect it to our power wire and get our lights working. All right, guys, so there they are wired in. I'm gonna give a better shot at nighttime. I'll edit that video in of what they're like at night. I'll make sure they're aimed correctly, but I have them at a 45, plus there's the side shooter on there. So we'll see what that looks like whenever it gets dark, but there we go. So I ran it through the cowl. I left it up for a little bit so I could show you guys, but I ran it right underneath there. On the inside, so it's not showing in this crack, but it's actually up underneath the cowl by the windshield wiper motor. But pop that down, because it's just snapped in there. Once you pop the hood open, you can access it from this angle here and get like a coat hanger up in there. But the way it's wired is through the auxiliary 3 port. You can see there, and then I got it connected to that bottom left, that first ground. It goes up into the cowl area, and then underneath the cowl to the other side, you can see the wiring in there in that little hole. So that's how it is connected up and good to go. So we'll see what they're like at night and let you guys see that. All right, so I wanted to show you guys what the night shots look like with these pod lights. So those are my normal low beams. There's the high beams, and I'll turn on now the auxiliary 3 for the other lights. So a little bit of a reflection off the hood, but you can see it lights up this area really good. I'll turn them off again. Quite a bit brighter. See over there as well. Again, these are my ditch lights for deer and so on and so forth. Also trail riding if you want to see where you're going to turn. But you can see it really lights up the night. And those side shooters are right there. Those are what's really reflecting on the hood. So what I'm gonna do is take some black vinyl and tape off the inside portion of the side shooters and leave the outside portion of the side shooters actually so that it shines off to the side. You can see over here, I got a tinted window, but roll the windows down and you can see it's pretty bright over there. So there's with the lights on, I'll turn them off. So quite a bit of a difference with those side shooter lights on there. Really, really nice, I think. So gives you plenty of view of what you're seeing at nighttime. Pretty significant, actually. Pod lights installed, got the rear tail lights installed. And so that's pretty much what we did with this video. A lot going on. Like I said, we got more to come on the Mustang. That'll be the next couple videos probably. And be installing things, taking things off, getting this ready. So if you guys like what you see on this video, again, make sure you guys follow me at my Instagram account right here. And the Instagram account for the Bullet is right here. And make sure you guys subscribe, hit that notification bell. I'll see you guys next time. All right, take care.